Right, so welcome to yet another episode of my Kerbal Space Program career mode videos, where today we are going to do some test flights of the upcoming space of the spacecraft for the upcoming manned space flights. You can, I think you can see here the contract to recover a craft from orbit, and this video is the first one that I like 100% comment from the editing. I did not say anything in the recording, and I now have to base my talking on what I can see on the low resolution screen in the Windows Movie Maker. So I cannot really tell what you can see here, but it must be the contract to at first recover a spacecraft after a suborbital spaceflight, which we will do in the first launch. So after having accepted the contract, we can head over into the VAB, where you can see loading the Mark 1 craft that I also have uploaded to the Steam Workshop. So you can download it from there, and I will place the link in the description. And in order to do the unmanned space flights, we will have, of course, to add a probe core and a sufficient electrical supply. And for the first suborbital mission, we will not, or the suborbital test, we will not need strap-on boosters, so we can go into the, we can place the build order. And I forgot to change the decoupler, and after having checked the staging and activated SAS, we can go. We can lift off, pitching slightly to the east in order to commence the gravity turn, and actually turn it light into a flat suborbital trajectory, which eventually will become and yeah, tipping over. This is a quite a consistent issue with this low level rocket, so let's do it all over again. And this is actually while time-lapsing the sample sounds like some strong wind blowing. And then we're coming this time to a nice stage separation, and carefully keeping the rocket aligned to the prog rate direction to prevent the aerodynamic forces from putting it out of control. Yeah, again, staging, and always check your staging. There was something not arranged properly with the exchanged stage separator instead of the stock, or instead of the decoupler that I placed originally. So yeah, there you can see the pod, and we have to do it all over again, except for the fact that we don't, because I flipped it again. Now in the third attempt, we are having a nice separation, and double checking the staging in order to prevent some mishaps like in the first attempt. But of course, this is the purpose of test flights. So everything is looking good, and we can coast until we reach yeah, a little bit higher, and start up the carrier engine, which now makes some different wind noises at 4x speed. Yeah, coasting until I think the carrier already puts us into the direction of space. And yeah, of course, extending the antenna. And then I placed some the test experiment from the Kemini science pack from the Nehemiah Orbital Engineering mod pack, which requires to run. That is also the reason that I deactivated the for science mod in my liftoff checklist, because the for science mod would just automatically collect the science data, and of course ruin the Nehemiah science mod. So yeah, it's now starting the, not really the deorbit, because of course we are not in an orbit, that's correct in the I do not even know, but anyway, we have completed the lab time for the test experiment, but unfortunately it seems like it needs a crew member on board the Kimini experiments in order to be functional. So this was all for nothing. And yeah, we are now entering the atmosphere and can separate the service module. Unfortunately, I forgot to retract the antenna, so it was destroyed by aero forces, but it's not that big of a deal because the antenna is a very cheap part, and if you cannot get the full recovery refund, that doesn't really matter. So again, the compressed air in front of the capsule is getting unlike some popular beliefs, it is not flames what you can see, but just ionizing gas from the heat from re-entry, and B, the heat is not caused by friction like at supersonic speed, but instead by compression in front of the space capsule. So we are now definitely slowing down, and deleting some messages. I don't know, I think you will be able to read them. I cannot right now. And the stability issues that it has at launch, the Mark 1, or generally the this launch vehicle, I named it Junkyard Rocket, size 1.2 meters or something. You can also download it from the Steam Workshop, and it has this stability issues, well, because it has them, but I did not detect them when creating it in the sandbox mode, where I just put some kind of control point which automatically can point into prograde direction, so then everything is fine. But when you have to manually point it prograde, you have to be very, very careful to keep it almost perfectly aligned, otherwise you will end up going the wrong way, because as everyone knows, the pointy end needs to point towards space, and the fiery end needs to point down, and if they don't, you will not be going to space today. So yeah, we are now slowly or gently gliding down on the parachute until we splash down in the ocean somewhere far off in eastern direction from the galaxy. And as I can see here with the green, have completed the return from a suborbital trajectory contract from the Career Evolution contract pack. Now head back to the KSC, where we can see the scientific results. I think it was next to nothing, and some nice refunds. And also, yeah, I was doing something with the notifications down there, and it has to have been something important, like they're seeing the Kerbin World First Record Keeping Society something notifications, and now being able to accept the contract to reach orbit and return. And a couple of days and two strap-on boosters later, we are ready at the launch pad, again lifting off, and again giving a little nudge on the yaw into eastward direction to commence the gravity turn. Again, it is all the same. Yeah, actually currently we are just flying on the Hammer boosters, which get staged now, and the BACC Thumper activated, and again at 4 times speed, sounding like some really strong winds, until it cuts off, and the second stage gets activated, which, as I explained, needs to be flown quite carefully. And you can see here now the very horizontal trajectory for the gravity turn, which maybe was not the efficient thing I've ever done. The most efficient thing I've ever done, as you can see, by a lot of propulsion energy being turned into compression heat. And yeah, now the... I think it Yeah, now the Terrier engine cuts off and gets engaged, so we will only be flying on the spark engine of the like the service module stage, and which then will carry out the orbital insertion burn sometimes later. But of course I need to show the extension of the antenna, because it just makes this small Mark 1 spacecraft complete. And I think I carried out one more collection burn there, as far as I can see from the noise level informations here. So now planning the re-entry burn in order to splash down relatively close to the KSC and the oceans of the KSC, but of course make sure that you splash down, because this pod is not equipped with landing legs, and so I don't like to land it on land, and of course I absolutely do not like to land it into the mountains that are somewhere a bit westward from the KSC, because landing anything that can go down on a mountain of course would be absolutely catastrophic. So we have completed the re-entry burn and can now jettison the service module stage, but of course we want to jettison it as late as possible, because it holds the octoprobe core. So as of now the command pod again is flying completely out of control, so being held stable by the aerodynamic forces. And again, I forgot to retract the antenna, but because it was uncontrolled, there was no way to fix it later. And now having the parachute extended, and yeah, slowly parachuting down until we gently splash down into the ocean closer to the KSC, so we will get more refunds from the recovery. And can see the notification that we completed two contracts from the Career Evolution Contract Pack and from the Kerbin World First Record Keeping Society. So now the way is open for the first manned space flights, which we will see in the next episode, and hope to see you there again. And as usual, if you enjoyed the video, you can leave a like and subscribe to my channel. And also feel free to check out my main channel that I have linked on my channel page, and I hope to see you again in the next video.